Hi children, good morning. This is the video number 22 from Current Electricity. So we are doing the numerical part of this chapter. I mentioned page number 127 of NCERT Part 1 so that you also can read the numerical before solving it after watching the video. This is 3.4 for numerical 3.4. It says that there are three resistors, 2 ohm, 4 ohm and 5 ohm are connected in parallel. What is the total resistance of the combination? So there are three resistances that are connected in parallel. So let us take the three resistances like this, 2 ohm, 4 ohm and 5 ohm. These three are connected in parallel like this. 2 ohm, 4 ohm and 5 ohm. Let us take them as R1, R2 and R3. They are asking us to find the total resistance of the combination. We know that the formula for total resistance in parallel combination is 1 by R equal to 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3. So 1 by R equal to 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3. Just we substitute the values. Substitute the values of R1 and R2 and R3. The value of R1 is 2 and R2 is 4, R3 is 5. 1 by 2 plus 1 by 4 plus 1 by 5 is 1 by R3. So 1 by R3 equal to what is the LCM of 245? The LCM of 245 is 20. So 20, here I get 10, here I get 5, here I get 4, I get 19 by 20. So effective resistance of the combination is 20 by 19 ohms. How much it is? 20 upon 19 ohms. This is for the first part. Now we read the second part. The second part of the numerical says that if the combination is connected to a battery of 20 volt EMF and negligible internal resistance, determine the current through each resistor and also the total current drawn from the battery. So here we have to find the current through the each resistance. So I gave a diagram as per the question. So here there is a battery connected across the combination. The EMF of the battery is 20 volts. 20 volt is connected here. So battery sends a total current of I. That total current gets divided into three branches as I1, I2 and I3. Since the battery has no internal resistance, whatever be the EMF here, potential difference, the same should be here. So here the potential difference should be 20 volt. Here also 20 volt. Here also 20 volt. That means since they are all in parallel, the potential difference across them is same. Now, how do I get I1? I1 equal to just apply Ohm's law. What is the potential of here? 20 volt. What is the resistance? 2 ohm. So I1 equal to V by R1. That is 20 by 2. I get 10 ampere. I2 V by R2. 20 by 4, you will get 5 ampere. I3 is V by R3, you will get 20 by 5, which is equal to 4 ampere. The total current is EMF by effective resistance. EMF is 20, effective resistance is 20 upon 90, total current is 19 ampere. Or you can have this value by just adding the three currents. I1 plus I2 plus I3, from which also you are going to get 19 amperes. So the total current in the circuit is 19 amperes and the current through each is first one 10 ampere, second one 5 ampere and third one is 4 ampere. So the total current is 19 ampere. Okay children, now we go for the question number 3.5. This question says that at room temperature,
27 degree Celsius,
the resistance of a heating element. So at room temperature 27 degree Celsius, the resistance of a heating element is 100 ohm. What is the temperature of the element if the resistance is found to be 117 ohm? That means they are given at T1, 27 degree Celsius, R1 is 100 ohm. At what temperature the resistance will be 117 ohm? They have given the value of alpha as 1.7 into 10 power minus 4. So this question is based, this numerical is based on temperature coefficient of resistance or resistivity. Okay, alpha. What is the formula for alpha? Alpha equal to R2 minus R1 by R1 into delta T. Of course, there is a different formula, but for you, this formula is okay. Alpha equal to R2 minus R1 by R1 into delta T. Just use this formula. R2 minus R1. What is the value of R2? 117 minus 100 divided by R1 is 100. Delta T, T2 is not known. T2 minus 27. This should be equal to alpha. The value of alpha is 1.7 into 10 power minus 4. Just we have to do calculation of this. Let us see how I am going to do the calculation. Take this T2 minus 27 to that side. 117 minus 100 is 17 by 100 into 1.7 into 10 power minus 4. Is it clear? Now, the 10 and decimal can be cancelled. 17 can be cancelled. 10 power minus 4 into 10 power 1, 10 power minus 3 goes to numerator, becomes 10 cube, which is 1000. Therefore, T2 equal to 1000 plus 27, which is equal to 1027 degrees Celsius. I hope it is clear, children.
It's a simple numerical. This is the way we find the resistance, sir, the temperature. Okay, children. Now we go for question number 3.6. This question says, this is 3.6, a negligibly small current is passed through a wire of length 15 meter and uniform cross section 6 into 10 power minus 7 meter square and its resistance and its resistance is measured to be 5 ohm. What is the resistivity of the material at the temperature of the experiment? So the length is given to you as 15 meter. First you do one thing, take the data. Length is given to you as 15 meter and uniform cross section means cross section area is given to you as A equal to 6 into 10 power minus 7 meter square and its resistance is measured as 5 ohm. R is given to you as 5 ohm. They are asking no. Such an easy formula. We have a formula that is R equal to rho upon L by A. So rho equal to R A upon L. What is the value of R? 5. Area is 6 into 10 power minus 7. Length is 15. So 3 times, 2 times, you will get 2 into 10 power minus 7 ohm meter. Such an easy question.
Okay, this is based on the relation between resistance and resistivity. Our resistance depends on what factors. Okay, children, next we go for numerical number 3.7. There is a silver wire that has a resistance of 2.1 ohm at 27.5 degrees Celsius. So, at T1, 27.5 degrees Celsius, the resistance is 2.1 ohm. Next. At temperature T 200 degrees Celsius, the resistance is given to you as 2.7 ohm. They are asking the temperature coefficient of resistivity of this
read the question carefully again. A silver wire has a resistance of 2.1 ohm at 27.5 degrees Celsius and a resistance of 2.7 ohm at 100 degrees Celsius. Determine the temperature coefficient of resistivity of silver. So we know the formula for alpha.
So in these videos, video number 21, video number 22, they cover 7 numericals of the exercise. In the coming videos, you will be learning the remaining numericals from the exercise part of the NCERT textbook. That much only I will discuss. So if you have any doubt, you can WhatsApp to me with your doubts. Thank you, children. Thank you very much.